Hi friends, we are seeing Angular team is focusing more on bringing features to improve the performance of Angular applications. I will say lazily loading module is the first step on that. Without lazy loading, all the components will be downloaded when the application is started. But with the help of lazy loading, we can split the entire application into modules and we can lazy load only the required modules. In this approach, only the required modules will be downloaded and so the initial load time comes down. Using this, we achieved module level optimization. But as we were bootstrapping the app module, the other third-party modules and components, those were mentioned in the app module, were also got downloaded when the application starts. Then comes standalone components. And because of that, Angular team removes the app module. Also, the good thing is, even the standalone components can be lazy loaded, and so we achieved component level optimization. So now, if we need to show only a dashboard component, we can lazy load that component alone. This is a huge optimization. But still, assume I have used many other components in my dashboard component. All these components will also be loaded. For example, consider this application. Here I have used 5 components in my app component. So when my application is loaded, all these 5 components will also be loaded. But only the first 2 components is visible to the user. The other components will be visible only if the user scrolls this page. It will be good if you have an option to lazy load the other components only when the user scrolls. In Angular 17, a new defer directive has been introduced. Using that, we can achieve this. The defer directive is a template syntax that allows us to defer the loading of specific parts of our application until they are actually needed. This is content level optimization. Not only this, we can achieve so many use cases using this new deferrable views feature. So in this video, I'm going to explain about this new feature. Let's start. First, let me show you how we can start using this defer feature. Here, let me wrap the last component inside a defer block like this. Now, this component will not be rendered initially. One important thing to note is, this will work only on standalone components. If this component is non-standalone, this will be loaded eagerly. Also, if we are using this component outside this defer block anywhere, in that situation also, it will be eagerly loaded. When we use defer on a template section, the content within that section is marked as deferred. This means Angular won't load the components, directives, pipes, and styles associated with that content during the initial render. So, when this content will be loaded? There are something called triggers. Triggers are events or conditions that signal Angular to load the deferred content. These triggers can be built in or custom defined. Once a trigger condition is met or an event is fired, Angular fetches the deferred content and injects it into the template. This ensures the content is loaded only when it is actually required. Okay, let me reduce the height of these components. Now we can see all the components are visible. You may ask me that I have told this component will not be rendered initially, but we could see it here. That is because I have also told that this deferred content will be injected once the trigger condition is met. And when we are not specifying any trigger, the default one is going to be on idle. That means the deferred content will be loaded once the browser has reached an idle state. Actually, we can specify the trigger like this. But as this is the default behavior, we don't want to specify this. If we refresh the page, we can understand. We can see the last component is taking a little more time and so it is blinking. Let me introduce an optional placeholder block. In this block, we can mention the content to be shown before the defer block is triggered. Let me give the placeholder component I have created. Now if I refresh, we can see the placeholder content is loading first and then the deferred block content is showing up. Whatever we are putting inside placeholder block will be eagerly loaded. Okay, let me try the timer trigger so that we can understand this defer concept more clearly. We can give the timer trigger like this. Let me give 3 seconds. So now, if I refresh, we can see the placeholder content for the first 3 seconds and then we can see the deferred content. Also, if I inspect and go to network tab and then refresh, we can see this component is getting downloaded after 3 seconds only. That means this is lazily loading. Let's also try the other triggers. Let me change this timer to interaction. Now if I reload the page, it won't show the deferred content unless I interact with that component. Let me click here. Now it is showing the deferred content. We can also specify a template reference variable on any DOM element and then we can specify that here. Now if we click here, it won't show the deferred content. Instead, we need to click on this component where we have added the template reference variable. Okay, instead of interaction, we can also use hover. In this case, this deferred content will load on mouse over. Here also, if I am not using template reference variable, this will be shown on hovering here itself. There is another trigger, immediate. When we use that, the content will be loaded immediately regardless of the browser state. When the deferred content is relatively small and is critical to be loaded, we can use this trigger. This ensures the deferred content is ready before any user interaction. And let's also see about another interesting trigger, viewport. To explain this, let me change the component height back to 500 pixels. Now let me reload the page. And let me slowly scroll. Once the deferred content comes into the viewport, the component gets loaded lazily. Let me show it again. Okay, we can also combine these triggers and achieve a more refined use case. For example, let me give a timer trigger to load my content after 5 seconds. And let me also give a hover trigger. Now if I refresh, it will take 5 seconds to load my deferred content. In the meantime, if I mouse over, it will load immediately. Similarly, we can combine viewport trigger and idle trigger and make sure it is either loaded if the user scrolls or let's use the browser idle time to download the content. This way, we can improve the user experience. Okay, similar to on triggers, which usually triggers on a specific event, we also have when trigger, which will be triggered when a specific condition is met. To explain that, let me create a button and on clicking this button, let me call a function. And let me create a flag and change that flag to true when this button is clicked. Now in the deferred block, let me use when trigger like this. So now if I reload the page, we can see the placeholder content is showing up. When I click the button, the deferred content will show. This looks like ng if, but it is actually not. I will explain the reason in a separate video. Okay, now let's see about prefetching. I have a requirement in which my deferred content has to be downloaded, but it should be shown to the user only when the user interacts. If I use interaction trigger and timer trigger like this, the deferred content will be shown to the user on interaction or after 5 seconds. But my requirement is just to download it and show only on interaction. In this case, I can use prefetch like this. Now, if I reload and click here, my content will be downloaded and shown immediately. In the meantime, if I reload and do nothing, after 5 seconds, the content will be downloaded. But it will not be shown unless I do an interaction. Okay, and before we close, let me explain about two more optional blocks. Similar to placeholder block, we can use a loading block in which we can show a spinner. Like this. So if I change my network throttling and reload my page, we can see the spinner when the content is getting downloaded. We can also specify when to start showing the spinner and how long it needs to show. If I refresh now, we can see initially the placeholder block is showing and then the spinner is showing. And finally, the deferred content is showing up. Okay, the last one is error block. This is also an optional block which we can use to show some content when we are not able to download the deferred content. To explain this, let me change my network throttling when this is trying to download the deferred content. Now we can see the error block. Hope you understood how we can use this defer feature, its options to optimize our Angular application and improve the user experience. That's all for today. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Share this with your friends and colleagues and leave your valuable comments in the comment section. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.